candidates and political parties are free to spend as much money as they can afford in next year's general election campaigns. This is after the electoral body IEBC withdrew the spending limits earlier on, published in the Kenya Gazette notice in response to a decision by the members of parliament who rejected the finance regulations due to a technicality. This essentially rendering a law enacted in May way back in 2013 meaningless for a whole 14 years, with the earliest implementation now expected in the 2027 general election, as Sam Gituku reports.
The Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission, in a Gazette notice dated 8th October, revoked the campaign spending limits that had provided for maximum expenditure by candidates and political parties, as well as maximum contributions by persons supporting a political party or candidate. IEBC is citing a resolution by the National Assembly that in late September rejected campaign financing regulations submitted by IEBC late July. The regulations were on campaign finances and how IEBC was to oversight political parties and candidates. That is now non-existent.
By default, the gazettement of the guideline will become null and void. That's why the commission degazetted it. And that's because the commission cannot enforce a law that does not exist.
In the now revoked spending limits, a presidential candidate had been allowed to spend up to 4.4 billion shillings in campaigns. Persons supporting such a campaign had been allowed up to 20% of contribution, meaning 880 million shillings, unless they are the candidate. For various county seats elections, candidates had been allowed to spend up to 21 million shillings in Lamu County, 117 million shillings in Nairobi, and a maximum of 123 million shillings in Turkana.
Unfortunately, the negative part of it is money will play a bigger role in our campaigns than ideology and ideas. So there is no regulation, which means political parties, any candidate, spend all their monies unregulated.
I think the public is losing, and the constitution is losing, and politicians are winning. They are winning because they are rejecting accountability and no one is holding them.
Campaign financing is a constitutional requirement under Article 88, Subarticle 4, Paragraph I, which requires IEBC to, quote, regulate the amount of money that may be spent by or on behalf of a candidate or a party in respect of any election. Parliament passed the Campaign Financing Act in December 2013, 9 months after that year's general election. That law was to be implemented in the 2017 general election. But in December 2016, 8 months to the 2017 general election, Parliament rejected implementing regulations submitted by IEBC. In January 2017, the law was deferred until the 2022 general election. Parliament did nothing about the implementing regulations between September 2017 and July this year. And in July, IEBC resubmitted the regulations tabled in 2016. The Committee on Delegated Legislation recommended to the House to annul the regulations, which it did on September 28th. Despite IEBC having published the campaign spending limits on the 9th of August, a year to next year's election, they have now had to take it back. The earliest the Campaign Financing Act can apply in a general election now could be in August 2027.
There's nearly 14 years of waiting to operationalize an act. There's no assurance that political goodwill will be there in 2027. So what we are seeing now is you may consider as political pushback and political impunity to frustrate regulation of campaign spending.
The decision by Parliament and later IEBC means that the 2022 general election will be an unregulated contest financially, open to manipulation by the highest bidder. For the electorate, it will be a struggle to sift through the money and the issues. Sam Gituku, Citizen TV, Nairobi.